Hello everyone, we're going to show you how to install the toolkit for Kentico. Adding the toolkit is going to make working with Kentico easier for both developers and marketers. Let's go through the install. If you haven't already, visit toolkitforkentico.com and hit the download section to download the install package for your version of Kentico. At this time, we support Kentico 8.2, 9, and 10. In the next couple of months, we will be supporting Kentico 11. We're going to work with Kentico 10 today, and I've already downloaded the K10 Toolkit install package from the site. With the install package downloaded, we need to log into the admin section of our Kentico site. I've already logged in as an administrator. Once you've logged in, you'll need to launch the Sites app from the Kentico menu. Once the Sites app has launched, we need to go ahead and import site or objects to bring in the Toolkit for Kentico module. We're going to select Upload Package, and from your download location, we're going to find our Toolkit install package. You can see I've already got it prepped here. We'll go ahead and select it and click Open. And we're going to select Next. Once the package has been imported, we need to make sure that Import Code Files, Import Custom Assembly Files are checked. Under the Modules section here, we want to make sure that the checkbox for Toolkit Extensions has been checked. Once all of that has been selected, we can move on to the next step. It'll take a little bit as the objects are being imported, and if all goes well, you can go ahead and click Finish. In this case, we don't have sufficient enough access on our server to be able to complete the install. So we're going to have to do a manual install of a few files to continue the process. Now I've already downloaded that same toolkit package to my server. So I'm going to go there and we're going to do a manual import. Now I've already RDP'd into the server and I've got my toolkit for Kentico installation package here. And I've already got my target location prepared. Once I go ahead and open up the package, you'll notice that we have a manual installation folder in there. And when I double click that, there's another zip. I'm going to double click that again. And you'll find the bin CMS modules, CMS pages, and CMS resources folders in there. We're going to highlight all of those and we're going to copy those over to the source directory for our Kentico installation. It's going to ask me if I want to overwrite everything, and I'm going to say yes. It'll take a minute just for those files to get copied over. And once they're copied over, we can go back to our Kentico admin interface and we can select Finish. You can see in the bottom that it's waiting for the server and it's going to take a little bit and may cause a recompile. Once the toolkit has finished loading, you'll notice the Sites app will refresh. If we go up to the Kentico menu though, you'll notice our toolkit isn't in one of the modules yet. So in order to make that happen, we just need to refresh to clear out the cache of the site. Once we've refreshed, the site's application will be open again. We can open up the applications list, close our configuration, and you'll see toolkit is now a module in the system. I can click on the toolkit icon in here to launch the toolkit application. Upon launch of the toolkit application, it confirms that you've gotten the toolkit installed and you're ready to use it. If you have any questions about installing, please visit the support section of toolkitforkentico.com or feel free to contact us, support@bizstream.com. Thanks.